About 6 years ago, I designed a control board for a high-power inverter that uses an iron core transformer, and it's still running strong today. Inverters with iron core transformers do have their downsides. They're heavy and not super efficient, but they're incredibly tough and can keep working nonstop for years. Today, I'm excited to show you my new design, packed with lots of improvements. This control module can be used to build inverters with power outputs up to 20 kilowatts. It supports systems from 24 volts all the way up to 196 volts. It also comes with a bunch of built-in protection features and lets you tweak settings right on an LCD screen. Thanks to JLCPCB for generously sponsoring this project. Many of my projects probably wouldn't have been possible without their support. You can support my work by using JLCPCB's PCB and PCBA services. Their service quality is among the best in the PCB manufacturing industry. This project took a lot of my time, so I can only share the schematic file with you. If you want the complete project for commercial production, please contact me through my personal Facebook. This PCB costs around $10 to manufacture and about $3.5 for shipping. It's really affordable, and you can also use the discount codes provided below. Some codes offer up to $200 off, which can help you save a lot of money. The 3D viewer feature from JLCB is really amazing. You can preview how your PCB will look before moving into production, and it also makes it easy to spot any mistakes on the board. Besides that, JLCPCB offers a wide range of other services like PCBA, 3D printing, PCB design services, and more. You can check out all their offerings on their homepage. After about 10 days, I received my PCB. The board looks great. I used a lot of vias to avoid ground loops, but it seems they didn't charge any extra for drilling all those vias. Really awesome. This is the LGT8F328 module, which I'm using as the main controller. It has a clock speed of up to 32 MHz, a 12-bit ADC, and many other features. Moreover, it's very affordable, only about $1 each. I'll solder it directly onto the PCB without using headers. For the surface mount components, I use an iron as a heat table to solder them. It works, but it's not very efficient. I recommend using PCBA services to save time and reduce the harmful effects of exposure to solder fumes. After soldering the SMD components, we'll move on to soldering the remaining through-hole components. To drive more MOSFETs, I used a totem pole driver for the output stage. A pair of TIP41C and TIP42C can easily handle 10 MOSFETs per side, allowing a total of 40 MOSFETs without any issues.
Vâng.
Here is the complete circuit after soldering all the components. At the top, we have four terminals for connecting to the transformer and the load output. Additionally, we have a CT current sensor, AC filter capacitors, and a voltage feedback transformer for regulation. This controller uses the EGS-002 to generate the sine wave signal. You should buy the genuine EGS-002 from EG Micro to ensure quality. There are many low-quality EGS-002 modules on the market, and they won't be reliable for long-term use. The screen used here is the LCD2004. It has four function buttons, back, up, menu, and down, and is connected to the main board via an 8-pin cable. This controller supports three temperature sensors to monitor real-time temperature. The temperature settings can be adjusted in the setup menu. On the main screen, it will display parameters such as battery voltage, DC current, AC voltage, AC current, AC power, frequency, as well as temperature and the inverter's operating status. All operational parameters can be configured through the settings menu, providing flexibility in both design and operation.